What is up? This is one big Bugga, and I'm coming at you with Euro Truck Simulator 2. We're continuing on with our haul. Of course, I've been the typical bad boy that I usually am, and that I did not upload on Friday. I meant to upload over the weekend to make up for that, as I most of the time am starting to do, and I didn't do that either. Shame, 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 shame. So, as always, I apologize for that. Like, I want to get 5 videos up more regularly, but it seems like my number is 4. But, anyways, let's get going. And the first thing I'm going to talk about here is something I'm a little unhappy with. And it's nothing, but it does have to do with Euro Truck. And in particular, SCS, the makers, the developers. And that problem is simply this. I just, you know, booted up Euro Truck and got a new update. And I'm like, oh, great. What's this? Is this going to screw up mods again? And the answer was no. It was a very small update. And I forget where I am. Okay. Just came over on the ferry, so we're back in Europe. I could have looked at the map and found that out. But no, seriously, this does bug me a little bit. As we all know, video game companies have been working to gouge out as much money as humanly possible. From people. EA is well known for this, although they've gotten a little bit better until recently with the whole Battlefront. And then if you want all the DLC, you can also buy the Season Pass for a grand total, if you buy the best package possible, of $120, which is ridiculous. We also had Deus Ex, customize your pre-order, which actually got such a terrible backlash that it got pulled, basically. People were so outraged about it that the whole idea was totally scrapped. Oh, I was gonna move lanes. Not now. So what am I gonna talk about? Well, I'm gonna be honest with you, this is gonna seem really, really minor and nitpicking, and maybe in the sense that it is, but it still bothers me because it almost feels like the beginning of things that could be worse. And it has to do with SCS and what they're doing. The new DLC we got for SCS was a add-on, if you will, to an old DLC pack. The Halloween Skins pack just got 2 new DLC. And they're 2 relatively small items. You can get a bat and a jack-o'-lantern for your cabin in your truck. However, in order to get this, in order to be able to do this, you need to have both the Halloween DLC and the new cabin accessory DLC. Now, combined, these are not a lot of money. I didn't look for sure. I don't remember how much the Halloween DLC is. I believe that it's somewhere around it might be $2, $3, something like that. Or it could be one of the ones that's like really cheap, 99 cents. I don't remember. The other one, the cabin DLC, which I think is a little bit ridiculous because it's somewhere around like $4 or $5 for that, which is the most that SCS has charged yet. Now, in order to get these two little items for your cabin, you will have to, if you haven't already, spend... Let's just argue that it's $2 and $4, okay? Let's just argue that. It could be $2 and $5. Let's just argue that. You're going to have to spend... somewhere in the realm... Well, you know, let's average it out. At best, even if it was 99 cents and $3, you'd still have to spend $4 for it. At worst, if it's $5 and $3, that's $8. Somewhere between $4 and $8 for this, two little DLC items. Now, the advantage is, of course, that you don't have to pay for it. And... running a little rough. I think I'm running a little bit rough in the frame rate because I need to dust out my computer. I didn't do it this month. I'm trying to do it, like, every other month now. Just to save on buying an air can every so often. But I need to do it this month. I need to make sure I get an air can this month. One way or the other, I've got to dust my computer out. But anyways, I'm sidetracking there. To me, this just sounds of greed. You know, you don't have a major title, okay, so maybe you can't squeeze every last little bit in big numbers out of it for people. But to still pull something like this just feels wrong. It really does. I mean, first off, you're not giving us anything significantly new other than two little figurines for the dashboard of the truck. And then in order to get that dashboard for the truck, we have to go and order two older DLCs that we don't already have, if we don't already have. I mean, if you already have them, great. Hey, you get these things right off the bat. So, this brings also a little bit of laziness. Instead of giving us new skins... and these little figurines, which would be a little bit better in a new pack. No, we'll attach these to an older pack, a year old, mind you. And you have to go and buy that. Plus, you have to buy our newest DLC if you want these two little items. Now, again, money-wise, it's small. But just because it's small doesn't mean you should be allowed to get away with it. The reality of all of this is simply that. It's a money grab. It's cheesy. And in my eyes... I'm gonna have to let him go. Getting a little bit too involved in what I'm talking about. Taking a bad corner, but it's alright. We only clipped the small sign, that's fine. Fortunately, our trailer's not too long. Where do you draw the line in terms of where you start to call out companies for being greedy? And for being lazy? For pulling things like this? To me, there shouldn't be a line. Whether you do it and you're grabbing for small shit, or you do it and you're grabbing for big cash, you know, shouldn't matter. You're still pulling the same trick. You're still asking people to shell out money for something that you already made if they don't already have it. And you're asking people to shell out money for your most recent one in order to get two tiny little items. And some people say, well, you know, you get those items, you know, for free as a bonus. If you're paying for something, it doesn't matter. It's not free. There was a story my wife and I used to laugh over all the time about her father, about how they were trying to talk him out of sending in for a free gift, because the way to go, Samuel. The free gift, in order to get it, you had to send $10, you know, shipping and handling. And it was a really small thing. That in no way, shape, or form cost $10 to ship. Even to Hawaii. If you're paying for shipping and handling, it's not free. You're paying. You're putting money out of your pocket to get it. These two little add-on items, you've paid, you know, you're getting little bonus if you've paid for the DLC already. If you want them, you gotta pay for the DLC. And I'm gonna be straight with you. There is no way, there is absolutely no way that these two little items are even near enough to entice people to buy these add-on packs. These DLC packs. And that's the other thing. I find it kind of hard to support SCS in terms of the DLC packs. The expansions, hey, no problem, I'm all over that. But the DLC packs? You're asking me to buy skins from you for $2-$3 when there are thousands of skins out there that are as good or better than what you're putting into the game for free. Now, if you want to make me some skins and ask me to pay a buck for them, sure. But to ask me to pay a couple dollars? Why? I'll just go get the free ones. I love your game. I love playing it. But you gotta realize what you're up against. You gotta make sure that people are gonna go for what you're asking for. And some of you could argue, well, if you really just wanted to support them, though, I understand that. I do. I did it again. I can understand just like buying them to support them. But when you're in a place like me, even $2 and $3 can make a big difference on have and have not at the end of the month. So it gets difficult for me. Now, for a lot of other people out there, maybe not difficult. And hey, if you want to buy them and you want to support them and you want to do this, go ahead. It's your choice. Again, as I said, I see this as a relatively minor thing, but it don't matter to me if it's minor or major. It doesn't matter if it's EA charging $60 for a season pass versus SCS asking you to go spend between $4 and $8 for a couple of DLC packs to get two more little items for my dashboard. It's still not worth the value. It still rings as just a little bit of a cash grab in my ears. You know, to give you an idea, in Second Life, there's the store that sells these amazing leather and latex outfits. They look absolutely stunning. But they only come with certain appliers. Appliers are things that apply the look of the outfit to certain mods that you may have on your body. Omega mods, one. Slink is another. And then there's one known as Lola Tangos. What are Lola Tangos? Well, this is where you kind of maybe like laugh a little bit, or maybe you cringe a little bit, or something of that nature. Come on, get past me. They're mesh breasts, basically. They're breasts that you can buy to put onto your character that look much more impressive, much more natural, and overall, you know, just better. And they're, in terms of game, very expensive. But that doesn't matter. It's just how, yeah, I should be running this section a little bit better. So I need to clean my computer. It's just heating up a little much. Nothing dangerous, just I feel like I should be running this area better. But anyways, the Lolas are some of the most common add-ons to a character that you'll see. And so very commonly outfit designers will will include appliers that apply the outfit look to the Lolas. Well, this store includes for Slink, includes for Omega, and includes for something else, which I forget. But it does not include Lola appliers. If you want to apply an outfit to your Lolas, you need to fork over another 100 Linden and buy the applier separately. Yeah, you heard that right. You have to buy the applier separately. Now that, in my eyes, is just not correct. And somebody tried to make the argument of... Way too fast, dude. Somebody tried to make the argument of, well, why make people that don't have the appliers pay for something they don't need? Okay. So then, why should I pay for the appliers of the stuff that I don't have? The Omega, the Slink. Why should I have to pay for those? Why aren't those separate? Why are those included? But not the Lolas. Simple. It's a way to make extra money off one of the most popular body mods in the game without having to raise your price. That's why. The reality is that people that have Lolas on their avatars are people who are that'll spend money. You may not necessarily have money, but you'll spend money to make your avatar look good. Versus people who don't have Lolas, you more or less, you're just content with how your avatar looks, however it looks. And you'll leave it at that. It's really that simple. If you wanted to include the appliers, you would probably have to raise your price a little bit. Now, granted, the appliers don't cost a lot. They're only 100 linden. And 100 linden in the game is chump change. Seriously. It's just nothing. But oh, hush. That still doesn't mean that it's not a cash grab to make you buy appliers for something that, in my eyes, should come with what the outfit that you're buying. Bella! I don't know why. She's been really aggressive lately. Barking at people and things that she shouldn't be. She hasn't gone and barked at the neighbors in almost a month. You know, I taught her out of that. Well, the past two times I let her out today, she hasn't gone as close to the edge as she usually used to. But she still runs about to a halfway point, and she's barking at the neighbors again. And I'm like, what's going on? It's really, really annoying. She's been very defiant lately, like she's trying to test me. And I've been getting really upset with her. And I'm not sure how to get her to fall in line again. But, anyways, that's really neither here nor there as far as I'm concerned right now. It's just, all of these things to me are just cash grabs, man. And SCS is doing it in such a small and subtle way that a lot of people will just tend to let it go, and I don't think that's right. I think you need to be called out on that. I still wouldn't be fully okay with it, but I would be more okay with it if SCS came out with new Halloween skins and added in these two DLC items, these two tiny little decorations for your dashboard into the new skins, and said if you buy this and have our in-cabin accessories, then I'm getting distracted listening to her. And the thing is I'm almost done with the trip. You know, but if you buy this new DLC pack and have cabin accessories, you get these two little items. I'd be more okay with that, but it would still be wrong, because it's still asking you for two little tiny decorations on your dashboard to go and buy this DLC and make sure you also get to have another DLC in order to be able to put them in your truck. That's still very wrong, but at least it takes out the lazy component of putting everything back onto an old DLC that's a year old. Hey, you know this DLC you didn't buy last year? Well, if you buy it now and you also buy this DLC, we'll give you these two little tiny trinkets. You know what it really is? You know what it really is? It is the free gift syndrome. But more than what I was talking about, you know, I heard a lady comedian talk about it before. It was the Avon free gift or the makeup free gift or something like that. And it basically went like this. If you spend $25 for stuff that you don't want, we'll give you $10 more worth of stuff you don't need. And that's exactly what this is. I don't want the Halloween pack. I don't want the cabin accessory pack. I honestly think the cabin accessory pack is dumb as compared to the skins. I really do. I like my cabin the way it is. Some people like it because you can decorate your truck much more authentic to Euro trucks. But that's also if you're using the base truck. Wow, I must have tapped that bus. Oh, well. You know, you can put up the windshield and window curtains and whatnot. Hang the stuff in your window. But here's the thing. All of this DLC that you can get, you can find in various mods for free. Again. Buy this stuff that you really don't want, and we'll give you this stuff that you don't need. That's exactly what it is. And I have always felt and will always feel that it's wrong. And I'm really disappointed in SCS about it. And you may ask why. Well, ask yourself this. Ask yourself this. Bad turn, I know. I just went with it. How long? Okay? How long before trucks become DLC? Because to me, it really feels like SCS is trying to push the envelope in very tiny increments to see how far they can go. How much we're willing to pay in order to have this stuff. Okay, there we go. That's really what it feels like right now. What will we buy? What will we be baited into? What is it worth to us? In order to have these little trinkets that you don't need. And that if you really wanted, you could get for free. I had it perfect, but it didn't register in my truck in time. Wrong gearing. That sucks. I had it perfect, but I didn't start turning the truck in time. Excellent. So, despite tapping that bus, we did no damage to the trailer. And, honestly, we didn't get, we didn't get penalized any kind of ticket or anything on that leg of the run, so that's pretty cool. I don't know, it's just, yeah, it's how I feel. It's just, it may seem ridiculous to say it. It may seem stupid. Especially when you consider how many mods are out there for this game. But I don't see it as that. I've always got a mind of this is video game industry that has stopped being about its customers and become a business. That has learned some very evil tricks of the trade. We'll do one more trip, then we'll go back and continue upgrading our other work truck. And that's the other thing that bothers me about this game as well when it comes to SCS and doing this stuff. Giving me free skins, giving me all this cabin stuff, hey, you know what, that's great. But it works in default trucks. It works in the trucks in the game. How many people do you think do like I do? Have a modded-in truck? Like this Freightliner. Or maybe have the K100 modded in. Or maybe have a different Kenworth. Or a different Peterbilt, have an American truck modded, or have a different European truck modded in. How many people do you think do that? I bet there's more people with modded trucks in this game than there are unmodded. And you're asking me to buy DLC for you that don't work with the mods. I don't know. I fear that one day, if you want to buy the next truck in line, if you want to play on the newest truck that they put in the game, you're going to have to pay for it. You're going to have to shell out that money in order to get the next new truck. Like, they're coming out with the newest Volvo again, so apparently Volvo's getting another update. I was hoping it would be a new man truck or something, but regardless of whatever truck it's going to be, they're coming out with a new Volvo. And it's the nosed Volvo. I forget what the name of it is. T-800 or something. I have no idea. That's a Terminator. But I fear that one day, if you want to drive that new nosed Volvo, which, by the way, there's a mod of that truck in the game that you can get and put into the game and have for free. But if you want to get the official version, you're going to have to pay for it. You're going to have to pay $5 or $10. For a new truck. You know, maybe it's just the way video game industry has conditioned me at this point. Maybe not. Nothing spectacular. Have we been there? No. God. Well, that's not necessarily the longest run. I have them lined up by price. But all of these are really small prices, man. And just not stuff I'm looking forward to doing. I don't know. I mean, I know that the Poland rebuilding map is not compatible with Rust map, but I wonder if Pro Mods is compatible with Rust map. Probably not, but I could look into it. I just want to hear Rust map's pretty good too, if it's as long as it's updated. Yeah, but none of these runs are particularly long, it looks like. Nope. That's not really long because that takes a ferry. That's 919. That's 953. That's not a big difference. 846. So we might as well just jump onto the Caterpillar, the 8-ton trailer here. Now, obviously, again, we're not going to do that now, the end of the episode. But, you get my point. Let me just take that trailer next time. So, yeah. I worry, man. This is a fun game. This is a great game, but. I worry. So how long does it take before other companies like SCS fall in line with companies like EA and start nickeling and diming you for every little possible thing they can? This is something maybe I'll touch more on, but the video game industry as a whole is losing faith more and more of its customers. We've shown quite solidly how much we'll support a good developer who treats us fairly. And the best and most shining example of that is still the Witcher series. That's still the biggest and best shining example of a good developer who has unwavering fan support. And just what the people will do for you if you treat us right. I don't know why companies can't learn that. Such as it is. Anyways, folks, that's going to be me done for this episode. I hope you've enjoyed watching this as much as I've been enjoying bringing it to you. Until next time, this is going to be one big bug, and I'm going to be signing out.